So I just thought, maybe inspired by Imam Hussein, one good quality that we can try to promote in our community, at least you know the few people that were here together, is to be non-judgmental. And I think Imam Hussein has done a great job with this. This whole family, Imam Hussein, Imam Ali alayhi salam, to bring this home to us, that this is a very important issue. You know, what they really cared about was that they wanted people to get close to God. If that's all you care about, if you don't want to say people are bad so that you feel good about yourself, then you will try to do things that reduce the cost of being a good person for others. Let me give you an example for this. You know, at home, sometimes this moment comes that you become angry. Like, I don't know if you've experienced this or not. Sometimes right before we get angry and like shout, there's this moment that we know if we continue with it, things are going to get out of hand. I don't know if you've experienced this or not. If not, then you're not as enlightened as me. Or maybe you're more enlightened. I'm just joking, by the way. This is something I will come back to it, right? I'll come back to it. So there's this time sometimes when you get angry, especially when you're trying not to get angry, there comes this time that you know, oh my God, if I don't control it right now, it's going to get out of hand. And if you don't, then it actually gets out of hand. So now you've shouted. Now you look at people around you, like, oh my God, what did I do when the anger is gone, right? You're kind of embarrassed, right? And you're like, they're thinking, well, what's wrong with him? Like, what got into him? What happened? So you're really embarrassed. Now, this, you could do this with your parents, you could do this with a sibling. It really happens. Like in a household, it's very difficult not to get angry, not to have these fights. It's bound to happen. None of us are infallible. This is something that I'm trying to point out today, that there's only a few infallibles in the world, which means the rest of us are not. That's just math. So at that moment when you've done that, imagine you've done that to your parents. You've got angry, you've embarrassed yourself, you go to your room, and now you feel bad. So now you want to go back and fix this, right? Now let's go to another perspective, the perspective of the parent. Okay, so we're shifting. See dramatic things I'm doing. So we're shifting from your mindset to the mindset of the parents. Now, what are they doing? What's going on in their head? They're like, my son, I raised him, I fed him, now he's shouting at me. So you're kind of upset, you're heartbroken. Now you can also make two decisions. One, you let that heartbreak conquer you and control your actions so that when your child comes to you, you make them know what they did. You really broke my heart. What did you do? Or if they did something to your mother, if you did something to your mother, what did you do to your mother? That was not cool. What will this do? Of course, that person has an ego. It just makes it more difficult for them. And you must have experienced this. Often what happens is that they become defensive. Well, if I shouted, it's because you did that. That person just came to say, I'm sorry. But when you make it difficult for them, when you make them know that what they did is wrong, you're increasing the cost of being good. So that person, of course, he has an ego. What he will get on the defensive. So, well, you did that too that I shouted. You always judge me. You do this, you do that. Now let's take a few seconds back. If that parent His only intention is that at some point, I need to address the elephant in the room, by the way. Do you feel sometimes the sound goes down? I noticed it, just wanted to say. It's cool, it happens, like it's no big deal, right? Don't let it bother you. So, let's go a few seconds back. If that parent, at that moment, before the son comes to say, I'm sorry, all he cares about is that I want my son to be a good son. Breaking the heart of your parent is bad. So all I want for my son is to be good. So let's make it as easy as possible for my son to be good. Let's reduce the cost of being good. So when his son comes, he wouldn't say that, oh, you broke my heart, or you did this, or you did that. He would just say, you just wait. Let him apologize, accept it, move on. Don't step on his ego. If you step on his ego, it'll just get worse. And this is exactly what Imam Hussein, for example, did with Hur. So when Hur is regretting all his actions, and remember, this is the person who blocked the way of Imam Hussein. For all those days, he stopped them, he caused all those suffering, worries, stress for Imam Hussein, for his family. He comes to Imam Hussein, and you know, from a day before, he's shaking. People look at her and they see he's shaking, a grown-up man, because he's scared. What if I go there and, like, he doesn't forgive me? See? The ego is worried. What if the cost is too high? So he goes to Imam Hussein, and Imam Hussein doesn't say anything about what he did. And he told him, hold your head high. See, no cost, no extra cost for the ego. Because all Imam Hussein cares about at the end of the day is that I want her to become a good person. At the end of the day, that's all that matters to Imam Hussein. So why make it harder? So this is very important for us. Being judgmental, sometimes make it harder for people to be good. And Imam Hussein again has a hadith which is very beautiful. You know, it's lovely that he said this years before Karbala, years before Ashura, and he put it into practice. So you can't say he just did it. He says, if a person swears at you or says something in your right ear and then comes to your left ear or the other ear and says, I didn't do it, accept it from them. Why? Because if he now is coming to say, I didn't do it, means that he's not proud of what he did. Make it easy for him to be good. If you say, no, you did it, then you're just playing with his ego. You're going to make it harder for him to improve, to let go. When he says, I didn't do it, means he's not proud. He's regretting. Move on. Or there's this other hadith that says, If someone comes to you and says, I'm sorry, right? If someone comes to you, they've done something to you, whatever they've done, and says, I'm sorry, and you don't accept it, God will be mad at you. And he put this into practice. Hurricane, he said, I'm sorry. And Imam, without any extra word, just accepted it.